Hello and thanks for watching. Let's talk about how to achieve optimal patency duration in rodents. There are five factors influencing patency duration. The first one is catheter tip position. The second one is the closed system, as when you use a vascular access button. The third one is catheter material and tip profile. The fourth one, aseptic technique and sterile solution. And the last is the positive pressure technique. Let's talk about the most important one, which is catheter tip position. Catheter tip position is your most important factor. The tip must be positioned in the ideal location for optimal catheter patency duration. So you need to be able to predict where that tip is going to end up when you do the surgery. And the way to do that is by defining your correct catheter insertion length from a landmark to an ideal tip placement, which will vary, of course, with the different vessels. You need to use the landmark to position your vessel ligature placement, and then the catheter color, if it touches that ligature on its proximal aspect, you can predict where that tip is going to be when you do the surgeries. There are actually three different scenarios when it comes to catheter tip position. It can be either too short, ideal, or too long. Too short of an insertion length will result in a suboptimal patency duration, and a thrombus will form and the fibrin sheet will form quicker, occluding the catheter tip. Will not impact the recovery, however. What you want the tip to be is, of course, in the ideal position, where you will have your optimal patency duration and the optimal recovery of the animals. Too long also will result in a suboptimal patency duration, and it actually can impact the recovery of the animals. Our second factor is the use of a closed system. So let's talk about that. One of the ways to get a closed system is using a vascular access button. So what is a vascular access button? It's the latest technology to access the vascular system and other organs or ducts. It features an external port with a silicone septum, a disc that will be placed subcutaneously, and a connector or connectors to couple to the catheters. It must be used with a pinport injector. If you use a regular needle to access the port of your VEV, you will damage that septum. So why should you use a VEV? As I just mentioned, the first reason is that it provides a closed system, but also allows for the catheter to be placed completely subcutaneously. And what that does is actually prevents the evaporation of fluids through the catheter walls. Both of these, in return, extend catheter patency duration. It's also very user-friendly. You have easy and clean connections, and also reduces the time and the frequency of the catheter maintenance. There are other good reasons to use the VEV. One of them is that it improves animal welfare and experimental results. You have minimal handling of the animal, you can have low stress sampling and infusion, and you can also group out the animals when you put a protective cap on the ports. There's also less stress on the technicians, and it supports the three R's by refinement and reduction. Now let's take a look at a study that was done by Charles River on CD1 mice. The study evaluated three catheter maintenance schedules in exteriorized catheter and transcutaneous buttons, which are the VEVs. The three maintenance schedules were 3 days, 5 days, and 7 days. Let's now take a closer look at four of the graphs from the study. On the left-hand side, we have mice with exteriorized catheter, and on the right side, we have the mice with the button. The top two graphs are flushing schedule of every 3 days, which is recommended with mice with exteriorized catheter and an open system. And at the bottom, we have a flushing of every 7 days, which is recommended for the VEV in a closed system. The colors of the graph now. We have blue, which is fully patent, so infused withdrawal, no problem. In red, we have patent on flush. That means you try to withdraw, it didn't work. You infuse some flush solution and try to withdraw again, then you're able to withdraw. In green, it's partial patent. You're able to infuse only. And in purple, you have non-patent. Catheters do not work at all. If we look at day 10 here, and I'm picking day 10 because animals usually would recover for 7 days after surgery prior to being enrolled in a study. So at day 10 here, we have 50% of the catheters that do not work already. So half your mice are not usable. If we look at the end of the study at day 46, 90% do not work and only 10% work. Now let's look what's happening on the button side. On the button, we have at day 25, all catheters are working, fully patent. And at the end of the study, day 46, we have 80% that are working, a 10% infuse only, and one that's an unpatent. So we actually have pretty much a complete opposite here as far as catheter patency. Flushing every 7 days is pretty much the same scenario. At day 11, 50% that work, 50% already with some issues, either non-patent or patent on flush. And if we look, at the button at day 31, they're all working still, so fully patent at day 31. And at the end of the study, again, pretty much a complete opposite. So now we can see that using a VB really do increase the patency duration. Let's look at factor 3, which is catheter material and tip profile. Polyurethane, silicone, and polyethylene are three types of catheter material. Polyurethane is the most used and recommended for catheter material. It is not as permeable as silicone and as stiff as PE, which is really good. It is also best for subcutaneous connection. So when you actually connect your catheter to the VEB, it's very important to have a secure connection. Now the different tip profiles. We have three different tip profiles. You have round, square, and bevel. Anytime that you can use a round tip catheter, that's what should be used if you're looking for long-term patency. The round tip minimizes the vessel wall trauma as the catheter is advanced in the vessel. That way it will inhibit fibrin sheet and blood clot formation. If you cannot use a round, then you have to go with a square tip. And if you do a very short study, it's also okay to use a square tip. The catheter tip should never be beveled when you're putting a catheter in the vascular system. Let's take a look at another study that was done by Charles River, this time on Sprague-Dawley rats, and looking actually on its impact of tip profile on catheter patency. Group 1 and 2 were done on femoral vein, and both had round tips, so we will not look at these two groups. If we look at group 3, 4, 5, 6, we have group 3 and 4 that were done on femoral using a round and a blunt tip, and group 5 and 6 were done on jugular vein using, same thing, a blunt and a round tip. Group 3 and 6 were using the round tip catheters compared to the 4 and 5 that used the blunt tip. You can see how much the profile of the catheter tip impacts patency duration. Our fourth factor is aseptic technique and using sterile solutions. We know it's important to follow aseptic technique during surgeries to prevent the risk of infections, but we also want to prevent the risk of biofilm formation. If you have a biofilm forming at the tip of the catheter, of course, it will shorten the patency duration. So we must use all, of course, sterile catheters, VBs, supplies, again, maintain aseptic technique, but also use pharmaceutical-grade sterile flush and lock solutions. Our last factor that influences patency duration is the positive pressure technique. So what is the positive pressure technique? It's actually just a very simple thing that you can do when you are disconnecting the syringe from your VAB port after you're done locking the catheter. So as you are removing the syringe from the port, all you have to do is to apply some positive pressure on the plunger when you remove the syringe, what that does actually prevents blood from entering the catheter at its tip and then forming a blood clot. So that means, of course, if there's no blood clot forming, then you have a much better chance of a longer patency duration. If you want more information on this, please go on our website and look at the video that we have in the blog talking about positive pressure technique and really how it affects the patency duration. So now, in conclusion, patency duration can only be achieved if you adhere to these five factors. At the same time, you will support the three R's by reduction of the animals that will be needed when you need vascular access in your studies, and also by refinement, because you're going to improve the animal welfare by stress reduction and group housing when you use that VEB. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.